We are in the heart of Europe. The European Central Bank's seat is here in Frankfurt, right slap bang in the middle of Germany, a powerhouse destination steeped in history and very affluent as well. Financial center here, key part of the business world. Who's going to take care of business this week? Who's going to profit on the grand stage of the Infinity Arena here? The first ever WTT series event to be staged here in Germany, the third WTT Champions event of 2023. This is WTT Champions Frankfurt 2023. And this is what we've got to look forward to here. In the opening session, we have the top 30 by ranking here, a couple of wild cards in each draw. It's straight knockout. We have the likes of Linda Bergstrom enjoying the best year of her career, a WTT Series final recently there against the German wildcard Sabine Winter. We have Wang Chuqin, who won the WTT Star Contender Lanzhou recently there involved as well. And the Olympic champion, Chun Meng, as well. Later in this long first session of play, the evergreens, Lee Sang-soo of Korea Republic against the German legend here in Frankfurt, Timo Boll, is in action. Fu Yu, done so well in European Championships in the past, the Portuguese against the rising star Xin Yubin of Korea Republic, while her compatriot Lim Jong-hun takes on Australia's Nicholas Lum. Lots to look forward to here in Frankfurt.
Please welcome world's number 70 from Germany. Make some noise for Sabine Winter.
And her opponent from Sweden, the world's number 37, Linda Bergström.
So here we are then, the grand stage of the Infinity Arena, where anything is possible. And here we are with the third WTT Champions event of the year. Best of five games here through to the semi-finals. The semis and finals in these singles draws play best of seven. First to 11 points in each game, with a two-point clear winning margin required always to take the game here. Tailor the table between these two, really intriguing first match of the week here with Bergstrom, the Swede, to take on fellow European, very experienced Sabine Winter. You can see it's a first meeting between the two at this level. And very similar, actually, in terms of their career-high rank achievements, just one spot between them. But Bergstrom at a slightly higher point in her career right now for all Winter's experience. Nazia Hakimara is our umpire for this first match. Long first day, two sessions of six matches. A lot of matches to get through, all round of 32s. But you've got to be on it from the get-go here, otherwise you go home. Players making their way forward then for the formalities after dropping their towels off and the coin toss, choice of ends. All those key elements for the matchup.
Thank you. Thank you. I have black and red. Black for you, red for you. It's red. Receive. Side.
So Bergstrom winning the spin of the coin, choosing to receive, and Winter getting the choice of end as a result here. Real buzz here around the place. Of course, table tennis so popular, so steeped in tradition in this country, here in Germany. And we've got a lot to look forward to this week. Bergstrom, 28 years of age, up and around that career high rank. Over a decade as a professional for the defender. Very, very much a modern defender, though, in that sense. Can transition beautifully, and we've seen a lot of that this season from her, not least in reaching the final of the WTT contender Rio, where she lost to Hina Hayata. Her opponent here, Winter, one of the host wildcard additions to the draws here in Frankfurt, but she's worthy of her place for sure. 15 years as a pro, key part of Germany's powerhouse performances over the years in continental events, team competitions, where they've dominated so much. This is what they're playing with on and for this week. Look at all of it, particularly the ITTF world ranking points on offer there. 1,000 points to the champion this week. We're going to get into the race to the WTT finals. This is one of the remaining qualifying events, and those points make a huge difference. You can make a huge difference to the fan vote as well, which is going the way of the German Sabina Winter. She's got a handy advantage there. I think the match is going to be a bit closer than that. If you want to influence it, if you're a fan of Linda Bergström, you can sign up to cast your vote. WorldTableTennis.com is the way to do so. And also a shout out as well before we begin for our social media coverage. Our digital team do a fantastic job. The hashtags this week to get involved, hashtag WTT Champions, hashtag WTT Frankfurt. There's lots going on. There was the player party, for instance. If you go on our social media channels, the Facebook, X, formerly known as Twitter, Weibo, YouTube, we got it covered. Player party last night, lots of stuff going on there with our digital team and what they were getting up to.
Winter versus Bergström, first game. Winter to serve, love all. One love.
A little bit of history then here. First WTT series event ever in this wonderful country of Germany, here in Frankfurt.
Love.
Fitting that we should have German interest in the very first match of the week. The experienced Sabina Winter taking on Swede Linda Bergström for a spot in the round of 16.
1-2.
It is a first meeting officially between these two, but they're two players, think of the continent of Europe. The European players know each other very well.
2-2.
It was interesting actually being around the main table here yesterday here in Frankfurt, seeing Winter going through her preparations.
3-2.
In terms of the German women's team, Han Ying as a defender, putting in a lot of time with Han Ying to get ready for the challenge of Bergström.
3-0.
Through to the first towel break, they split the first 6 points. But Bergström can offer a lot more than that, not just a pure chopper. As we've been saying, we've been seeing that this season. The results that she's been putting together, the Swede.
4-3.
Right, that's on fine to range, Winter. The loop. Just patience, as always, the premium quality, the most important quality required, in many ways, against the chopper. She's got that power as well, Winter. Can attack very hard. She's going to need a lot of this. Attacks just like this one.
5-0.
Tobias Bergman there.
6-5.
A part of the German setup.
6-0.
Nothing to separate them again through to the second towel break. A little bit of good fortune for Winter there.
6.
It's getting the blend of these attacks right as well. It's got very good feeling, Vinta. And she's going to need to demonstrate that as the match goes on. Straight through
6,
there.
8.
Good stuff here off the second tail break from the German. Pressure on her opponent here. This opening game, remember, best of 5 here. These knockouts, first game so important, setting the tone.
9-7.
An early look here at their service success relatively. You can see how Vinta has opened up an advantage there. Backing up her service with her attacks. Oh!
9,
that's
8.
Outrageous off the net there from Bergstrom. Check sideways almost here, this ball. That's a good example there with Bergstrom through to the third tail break where she's... able just to transition here, bring in a little bit more change of shape on her forehand there. Not just pure defense, more brush. Good comeback here. Ah, nicely onto the top of the bounce there. Anticipated that, Vinta. Such a character. Nice and low there, top of the bounce as well. Beautiful shot to bring up a game point. Takes it,
11,
the German
9,
with first blood here in Frankfurt. A game to the good, Sabina Vinta over Linda Bergstrom here. But as an opening game goes, that was quite watchable. First game gone then in Vinta's favour. 11 points to 9 over Bergstrom here.
Second game, Bergstrom to serve. Love all.
Linda Bergstrom with a bit of work to do then. Game down here in this first match of the week in Frankfurt.
Let love all.
Let service to begin game 2.
Love
reflecting
one.
On the opening game. Really impressive that Vinta did was how she kept her focus with these attacks over the course of that game. Finished very strongly. Talk a lot about her character. Fantastic crowds in here, actually. A word for that, what we're expecting through the week with the advanced ticket sales. Amount of interest around this event here. She's someone with a personality who can thrive in that situation. And some players might be a little bit overwhelmed by this. Wonderful arena, the Infinity Arena, the big stage. I don't think she's going to be.
Two.
really varying those attacks nicely. Nice and loose through the shot, Winter. Just the end of the first game and the start of this, underlining how well the Germans playing.
1-4.
A couple of points back for Bergstrom through to the first towel break. In some senses, mentioned she was doing a lot of practicing with Han Ying, but as they were to discuss Tammy Borosz and Winter this matchup, a lot of it you feel it's on her, the way she approaches it. In terms of her focus, how she varies the play. Bergstrom is a top quality player. You're going to get that really steadiness through her game. And then it's consistency there, how you consistently reproduce the quality required, varying it.
Four.
Oh. Any sort of drop off, Bergstrom will be right there. Beautiful point. Changing the direction well there, Winter. Shape as well of the ball. Variety in the attack. Trying to vary a service there, Bergstrom. Went to the tomahawk there. Nothing doing. Fantastic play.
Four.
Don't need to go to another level here in this second game, Winter, with the quality of these attacks. The wind up there, the lock and load. Too much for Bergstrom here at the moment. And slightly into the midsection there as well. Again, varying the placement here impressively. Winter, as well as the attacks, we know she's got that power. Just going there into the pocket area of Bergstrom to force the error.
Four,
saw Bergman
nine.
There, wondering about timeouts here because a bit of a quizzical look on his face there, how this has gone.
Nine, five.
I mean, she's lost the point there, but again, that's the variety just threw in that little drop. It's unlucky here. Again, varying the play, Winter. It doesn't work out there in the end that time.
Ten, five.
5 game points for the German. Through maybe as she was expecting there. Get to the third towel break and her home crowd here recognise it's getting a bit tighter now. 3 game points gone, 2 to go for Winter. Gets it done this time. Mini recovery from Bergstrom, but the tone was set. Winter playing very nicely here. And she's a game away from progress here in Frankfurt. 2 up now on Bergstrom. So there's the match situation. Sabine Winter needing one more game to make the round of 16 here. Two up now on Linda Bergström, winning the second 11-8. All the big names here this week. Let's take a first look at the week at the seedings here. Sha heading it up, of course, the standout player in the sport for so long. Big Chinese interest behind her as well. We'll see Chun Meng a little later on in this session. But of course, we also have Japanese and Korea Republic standouts. Hina Hayata in such good form. Mima Chan, Mimorito, and Shin Yubin also there. Of course, the top European, Han Ying of Germany.
Third game, Winter to serve, love all. One love.
Third game beginning. A lot of focus on Sabine Winter here playing at home, but just looking at Linda Bergström here, be interested a penny for her thoughts, in a sense, so far, how she's approached this.
Love two.
My feeling is, just feel like there could be a bit more variety on her part. Feel like the ball is a little bit samey here. However well Winter is playing.
One, two.
What I mean by that is, just think of the regulation, her stock shot when she's defending in terms of the backhand chop, the backspin. Just add a little bit more difference to that.
Three, one.
Winter enjoying herself off the service. I just think adding a bit of variety in general is the theme here. Serves are a little bit samey. Yeah, and there again, to back up the point I'm making here with Bergström. Yeah, Winter's had to work hard. You can hear the effort she's putting in there. But a lot of these chops, they're just straight backspin. Maybe think about putting a little bit more side sometimes. Just give a different look in the chop. I feel like Winter's getting into a rhythm there, knows what's coming, nature of the ball. And here's the timeout called by Tobias Bergman here. A rhythm. That all said, the German crowd here, Frankfurt crowd, are delighted with this situation.
4-1.
Tamara Boros will as well. Winter looking very good for progress right now, resuming a 3-point lead, game three.
2-4.
So much German representation, of course, here as well this week. Mentioned Han Ying around as the top German woman. Five German women in the main draw here. Oh, it's caught the back edge,
Two,
yeah.
5.
No chance for Bergström here off this drive. Loaded with spin and just catching that back edge for Winter for the point.
5-3.
We have five German women, six men. Men's draw we'll be focusing on as well. 20 member associations represented overall. Into the pocket area again, the middle. Talk about maybe a lack of variety from Bergstrom. There's been plenty of variety, particularly in placement so far from Winter here. Thinking very clearly out there.
Seven.
Bergstrom did try to attack on the receive there, flatter rather than chopping, but nothing doing.
Three, eight.
Lady Luck smiling here on Winter. Not that she really needs it right now, how well she's playing. Another good run of momentum being built up here for the German.
84.
That might have just caught the top of the tape on the way through from Bergstrom. Changed the flight and direction of the ball. Tobias Bergman here and Tamara Borosz. Had that one timeout for the Swede. Still trails by four.
Nine, four.
The thing here as well is it's just the strength of the sport in this part of the world. You've got Winter coming here on a wild card, 70 in the world. And you wouldn't know it. I mean,
four,
she's been a top 40
ten.
Player to have those continental achievements, but it's just how the fact anyone can beat anyone pretty much in this sport, such as the depth. Six match points. Oh, fortunate
11.
Ending.
Four.
Nothing much fortunate about that victory for Sabina Winter. She's been class here in front of her home crowd. The first winner of the week here at the WTT Champions Frankfurt. Sabina Winter of Germany impressing in front of her compatriots, delivering on the big stage of the Infinity Arena and making progress here. Germany's Winter in straight games, 11-9, 11-8 and 11-4 over Sweden's Linda Bergstrom. This is how it ended up. Winter just too good on the day, defying the rankings. I mentioned that can happen. It happens in world table tennis. Anyone can beat anyone, especially in such a high-level competition that we've got here this week in Frankfurt. And immediately off the bat, evidence of that. Match summary then, 21 minutes. Pretty routine for Sabina Winter. Played very well, dominating behind his serve, as we highlighted in the commentary on a few occasions. And Bergstrom just maybe paying for a little bit of lack of variety and unpredictability in her game in that one. So, first match of the day, done and dusted. What about this one? Next up, Wang Chuqin, world number two. The winner of the star contender Lanzhou recently against one of the rising stars, the movers and shakers of the sport right now, Chinese Taipei's Gao Zhengrui. That one is coming up next here in Frankfurt. We'll be right back. Infinity Arena here in Frankfurt, the WTT Champions Frankfurt. This is the grand stage of the sport, the redevelopment of table tennis, world table tennis. Just think about what's happened over the last couple of years, what we've been treated to and what we're going to be treated to this week. Already a victory for home player Sabina Winter of Germany. Later, more women's singles round of 32 action, the Olympic champion involved Chun Meng. But before that, let's get to our next match and the introductions as we turn our attentions to the men's draw.
He is 18 years young in his first pro year. From Chinese Taipei, Cao Cheng Shui. Please welcome from China, world's number two, Wang Shuxing.
Really looking forward to this one. The big man, Wang Shuxing, one of the key figures, I'd argue, in world sport right now, not just in table tennis. True star, icon, and into action here again. Someone who's won the big titles, including at WTT Champions level before. And his opponent here is so intriguing because we have a young man here in Gao Zhongrui, 18 years of age, first full pro season, and he is already lighting it up. I just saw there a best of five game encounter. Say here it's a first meeting here between the two, but they did actually meet very recently at the Asian Championships at the international events level in Pyeongchang, where Gao took Wang to five there. And that's an omen for today's encounter here in Frankfurt. Of course, a chasm of experience already between them. Wang has been to world number one earlier in the season, has won multiple world championship gold medals, everything else besides, and he's a big favourite here. Christoph Geiger, a big favourite here too. One of our officials for the week. An umpire for this one.
Wang, please get ready for the toss.
Wang Shuxing with Wang Hao, just waiting for the second seed in this draw to make his way forward.
What do you choose, yellow or green? Green for Cao, yellow for Wang. Yellow wins, Wang won the toss. What do you choose? Receive, decide. Good match.
So the spin of the coin won by Wang Shuxing, choosing to receive first here in this one. Guy McCree with you at the moment here. Take you through this one. We'll be joined by Fraser Riley later in the commentary, but for the moment here we continue and we have a look at one of the movers and shakers in the sport right now, Gao Zhongrui, 18 years of age, first full year as a pro, and already up, directly qualifying by rank into a WTT Champions event. Meteoric rise for the young man from Chinese Taipei, up 116 spots in the past 12 months alone. His opponent, well, you're going to know quite a bit about this guy already. 23 years of age, has been world number one. It was around the time of the star contender event in Ljubljana earlier in the season. Almost a decade as a professional. Think of him winning the men's doubles gold Budapest World Championships 2019 with the great Ma Long. And what he's done since then. He's a contender here to win the title. $30,000 on offer to the champion. 1,000 ITTF world ranking points as well, which will really Wang is looking for in his ongoing tussle with his compatriot Fan Zhendong for the world number one ranking. Not much separating them in the roll-on rankings right now. But there is something separating these two. If we look at these two here in the fan vote, with Wang very popular, taking 69% of it at the moment. But Gao's winning new fans all the time. And if you're one of them, worldtabletennis.com is the place to go to cast your vote for him.
First game, cow to serve, love all. Let, love all.
Let's serve to begin here then. Second match of this opening day. Eight action-packed days of competition in store here in Frankfurt.
One love.
We have one of the rising stars of the sport here against one of the established figures. Cao Zhongrui against Wang Chuqin.
One all.
Good stroke of luck there for Wang. And the second point of the match.
Two, one.
Interesting dynamic here. Wang Chuqin, 23 years of age, veteran. You think of it in this way. I have to couch that as a word to describe it. He's been around so long already, and now he's meeting these
one,
hungry
three.
Youngsters. 18-year-old Cao Zhongrui. He'll be keen to make his mark here, stamp his authority on this, especially after the very close match they had in Pyeongchang recently.
1-4.
Some entertaining rallies already here. Very optimistic open style that Gao has got. Really backs himself, whatever the situation.
4-2.
And of course, when you pushed Wang so close so recently, that gives you confidence. Even if he did get edged out in five, would have taken a lot from that. Seems to be someone as well who's learning quickly, embraces that information, which is all important, win or lose.
5-2.
And again, he's going to get a top-level education here. Who's at the other end of the table? Wang Chuqin, just up there as one of the very best.
2-6.
Absolutely loaded there. Try to shuttle
seven.
That through quicker, deeper. Wang was alive and stretches the lead here to five.
8-2.
And he has really put his foot down here in recent times. And that one fired at Gao's chest.
Let. 8-2.
It's so important for him to get a read on this service of Wang as well. That just isn't
Nine,
happening
two.
In this opening game. Wang varying, as he always does. Gao at the moment, that receive push just popping up. He's not reading it. And there we go. Hasn't dropped a point on serve yet, Wang. Of course,
three,
as we flash
nine.
That up, that record goes, but it doesn't change the general flow point here for Gao, but it's from a long way back. Zhuang Zhiyuan, who's entered, actually, he's in the draw here. Former Grand Finals champion, as it was then, 2002.
4-9.
Come on, come on! Early cider there for point of the day. These two are making their case, and they're making a strong one there. Fantastic
Nine,
stuff
five.
From both. Ridiculous ball striking there, so far away, wide of the table. The control, and the crowd appreciate it, as they should. Both need a little breather after that, understandable. Thrilling point.
Nine, six.
Bit of vocalization there from Gao as well.
Display. Six, ten.
One there taking a couple of extra moments. He pushed it on by the umpire. It didn't seem like it was particularly long, though, but he did just pause, and that's his experience there. Steady himself, and of course, the great man in his corner there, Wang Hao, watching on. Four game points here.
11-6.
Clinical.
Game two. One.
Off and running here. Wang Chuqin. The opening game off Gao Zhongrui here in this one in Frankfurt by an 11 points to 6 scoreline. That was a really good opening game from both. Wang Chuqin taking it. This was the point of it, without a shadow of a doubt. Look at this, real time. He's talking about the people in here. Come along to a World Table Tennis event. Because our team do a wonderful job. But if you're in here as well, the pace, the movement, just the sheer quality of these athletes, you have to get in the arena if you can when World Table Tennis rolls into your part of the world. That point there was a good example of it. Ticket sales, actually, this week.
Time.
Fantastic. Around 3,500, I think, over 3,500 seats available here in the arena. So just seeing that, watching our pictures here, you can see how good the attendances are. And
second game,
even more over
serve.
The course of the day.
Love all.
And that's because of the all-star cast that we've got here. Word gets around.
Love one.
Where quality goes, people tend to follow in number. That's my view anyway. Had some quality here. What can Gao do early in this second game?
One all.
Just something to follow here in this second game. Mentioned in the opener is about the read on the receive, read of the serve here. He can do a better job with that. Oh, he's there. So strong there. And it's just it's his technique as well, his footwork. Look at him out of end of range there. Brilliant. And then over
one,
the table
please.
As well. Very good. Keeps that bat nice and high as well. Just very strong, very solid.
Two, three.
Stamp of frustration.
Three all.
First towel break of game two. Gao's body language is interesting to me. Feels like he's on the edge of something here. Feels like he's close. Without quite delivering yet.
Three, four. Five, three.
Receive into the middle. Another area as well. Look back at this point. You saw the previous point from Wang. It's just his touch play as well. Talk about it, quality of his service, and Gao struggling with the receive, but it's also his touch play, short play, short game, if
left,
you like.
5-3.
You know, that point, a couple of points ago, that push, you think, okay, Gao, how's he missed that? But it's just, it's the quality of Wang's ball in the first place. It's forcing the error.
Six, three.
Excellent control again. Is Wang going to do a similar thing here to the first game and pull clear midway through?
3-7.
Just puts the hammer down. You don't win all the matches that he's done already and all the titles without being able to do this. Pretty much just switch it on when you like. 3-3. Okay, I'll go and reel off 4 straight points now. Not so fast, Gao.
4-7.
That little fish away there. Still a lead of 3.
Seven, five.
Down to 2 here at the second towel break. Service, of course, will be back with the Chinese.
Six.
Mm. Like that. Maybe spin there and coming back here.
6-8.
Just nips the run in the bud for the moment.
Stop. There are 2 pieces of rubber on the table.
Stopping for a minute here, a couple of bits of rubber, causing to Christoph Geiger onto the table.
6-8.
Keep that surface absolutely clean and bone dry.
7-8.
Brilliant,
eight.
Over the table there, Gao. Made that look so easy when it wasn't. Maybe just for once there, one. The push popping up a little bit. There was still a lot to do over the table there, and he did it very well.
9-7.
Just an edge coming around to take the backhand there, making the adjustment. Missed that shot earlier in this game, but no mistake here to build the platform to dominate the rally. With the service 2 away from a 2-game lead, 1.
10-7.
Brings out the firepower. Muscling through, even those relatively tacky rubbers. So much power. 3 game points.
11-7.
Too much for Gao there.
Game 2, 1.
That's the champion's resolve here in Frankfurt from Wang Chuqin, doing what's required. Doesn't seem totally happy with his performance there. That's the standards he sets. But he's 2 up now, all the same, on Gao here. 11 points to 7 for Wang there in the second. The rankings, the great and the good of the sport right now. In the top 10 in the world, and this ongoing, if you like, a bit of an arm wrestle between Fan Zhendong and Wang Chuqin at the moment. You can see here, that's why this week is so important here, with just over, what is it, over a couple of hundred ranking points between them. They've been swapping around the last few months. At the moment, Fan is the king of the hill. He actually plays later on. We're really looking forward to that against Truls Morgaard. Repeat of the 2021 World Championship Final. fun in action later, and always a pleasure to watch him.
Time.
Und nochmal ein Applaus für beide Spieler hier vor diesem dritten Platz für Wang Shuxin und für Cao Chengzhu.
Third game, Cao to serve, love all. Love one.
Torches the line of the table there, imperiously won. It's not a bad drive there from Gao, and he dismisses it, the Chinese.
One all.
There have been signs of improvement here. Gao has not played badly. I think we often have to say that the standard that these top guys set, I think you have to pay homage to that.
1-2.
Can still draw on that recent meeting, going to five, the fact he took him to five, even if he's two down here, and just think in the wider sense, look to learn from every point here.
2-2.
End of the previous game, early this one, continuing to control proceedings.
3-3.
Just reflecting back on the previous game where Gao was closer. By all accounts, I know he only won one more point, but yeah, numbers, those pure points numbers, don't often just match what we saw. He was a bit closer than that. He was varying the service and actually just taking a bit of pace off the ball as well. We saw the shovel serve in the second game.
4-3.
You know, all players like rhythm, whatever the level they're at. I'm not saying one couldn't deal the variety brought in, but you've got to try. Something we're saying in the first match of the day.
3-5.
Keep the opponent guessing, and that's what Gao off the service was able to do a bit more in game two.
Timeout.
Got a timeout here now. First of the match. John Ji Yuan has called it.
Timeout. From Cao Chengzhu. Im dritten Satz beim Stand von 3-5.
Win or lose here, Gao Zhongrui, look at the last 12 months here. One of our key movers and shakers. These are the top 50 players right now, and you can see what this young man, teenager from Chinese Taipei, has been doing. 116 spots in the last 12 months. That takes some doing.
Time.
As I'm saying here, he's directly in on rank as a result at 34. He's someone, as I say, regardless of what happens here, you're going to see a lot more of in days, weeks and months to come here in world table tennis.
3-5.
Resuming with the service, 2 adrift.
3-6.
Again, no disgrace here if he does go on to lose to Wang Chuqin, but it's what you learn out of it and how you commit to the matchup.
7-3.
And the Chinese Taipei set up, they're very meticulous. They've got great knowledge. I mean, just look at the man who's on his bench there as well. Chuan, who's giving back all the time, and I'm sure will continue to do even when he finishes his pro career.
7-4.
And it's the question of how, even for them, how they replicate this quality of opponent in training. Well, if you can't quite do that, these matches are all important when you're out there to be able to play, compete in them, and then study them afterwards.
4-8.
Study the quality of that ball. Point after point, setting the standard. One here.
There's
a quality service there off the high toss.
9-5.
That's quality as well, just nonchalantly caresses it away. 9-5. Play up and then just working it into the space.
10-5.
Wants another highlight reel moment as well, because he's about to get this done by the looks of it. One. So strong in every department.
11-5.
Yeah, I think he'll probably do nicely for the first match of the week. One of the title favourites, Wang Chuqin, just making a statement there to one of the movers and shakers. You're on the rise, but you're not beating me yet. Wang here delivers, takes care of business. Straight games, 11-6, 11-7, 11-5, and through to the round of 16 in typical style. The Chinese. There's the finish. Everything on show against a very talented opponent. We will see a lot more of, but we won't see any more of this week here in Frankfurt. It's the second seed has sealed the deal. Straight games, really impressive numbers all round. 22 minutes. Some good streaks in there, the highest of them. 6 points in a row as he took charge in those opening couple of games in it, behind serve as well. It was an area where Gao struggled really throughout, although he did improve a little bit as it went on. So next up, back to the women's draw here in Frankfurt with the Thai standout, Sini Sawetabut, to take on the Olympic champion. Second seed here, Chen Meng of China. One coming up very shortly. What a setting this is here. The organisers, the German Table Tennis Federation as well, doing a fantastic job here. Our thanks as well to the city of Frankfurt, the Hesse region, for their support in getting this event on. Really excited to be here, all of us. And a couple of matches done in this early part of the opening session already. Victories for Germany's Sabina Winter, and just now for Wang Qiqin of China. Next match coming up here. Let's get to the introductions for that one in the women's
draw. Let's start with a player from Thailand. Please welcome Sunasini Savetabut.
And here is the world's number two, the Olympic champion from China, Chen Meng.
So one of the leading lights for so long in the women's game, Chen Meng, enters the Infinity Arena for her first match of the week here at this WTT Champions Frankfurt. And a bit of a title drought, Chen. Looking to end it this week, the Olympic champion, in what will be to start with a best of five game encounter against the always improving top Thai, Suthasini Sowetabut. Of the table, they've met a couple of times previously. These two, Chen winning both of those, although Sowetabut in one of the meetings did win a game. It was at the World Championships in Budapest back in 2019. Chen Meng winning that 4-1 and also winning at the Asian Cup the previous year by 3-0 scoreline. Nico Zorm will be in the chair for this one. Third match of this day session, six round of 32 encounters, six more to follow in the evening session here in Frankfurt later on.
Okay, for you, green or yellow? Yellow? Yellow for you, green for you. Green, you won the toss. You change the side. Do you want service or service? Okay.
Sunasini Savetabut already competed at the Olympic Games 2016 in Rio. Big success for her, and she started her pro career at the age of 40.
So we can begin now. The coin toss out of the way. The 2 minute knock up here. Let's have a look at Simi Sowetabut here, 28 years of age, someone we're used to seeing in the WTT series. That's because of her ranking. She's an extremely solid player. I think of coming from her country as well, a powerhouse nation, but she really represents Thailand beautifully in terms of her achievements, her matches. And they'll be tuning in for this one against the Olympic champion, Chen Meng, 29 years of age now. At two in the world rankings. Very consistent. Look at the career win percentage, 85% there. But without a title since the Singapore Smash last year. So she'll be looking for these 1,000 ranking points on offer and the $30,000 to end the title drought, although she's made a number of finals in that time. Looking for her share of the $500,000 US dollars total prize fund this week in Frankfurt as well. Chen is dominating the fan vote at the moment, about three quarters of it. Sowetabut, though, very popular. If you want to back her, worldtabletennis.com is the way to do that. Sign up there and cast your vote to do so. Very solid here, Sowetabut, and real work ethic that she's got that you need to produce at this level. Can she take it to the next level, though, here? She'll need to. They all need to when you're up against one of the elite performers. Chen Lun trying to snap that title drought. And also in the wider context as well, you think of, for a player of her stature, the wider build-up to the Olympic Games next year, even players. I was talking to Dmitry Ovcharov about that, how they start to think about that. And these events are really important in themselves, but also in the wider picture of the Olympic cycle. A lot to think about for these big names.
First game, Zaveta would serve Lavoie. Love one.
The action beginning here then. Best of five, worth reiterating that, right the way through to the semi-finals of these singles draws.
One all.
Oh. Olympic champion at the table here, Chen Meng. Against the Thai, 39 in the world, 28 years of age. Sini Sawetaba.
One, two.
Oh. Loaded that. It's talked about the outset, a couple of elements with this that Sweater, but very solid, good base to her game. Does most things well, but.
Two, three.
The fact is, goes without saying, but in this situation against a player of this caliber, you've got to have the match of your career. Got to absolutely peak in every respect. That is the challenge.
Three, all.
I would say against that, though, that for Chen, as with every player here, first match of the week, getting used to the conditions. She, like all the top players, was on the match table yesterday, practicing on it, but under the lights, the actual competition, however many times you've done it, take a little while to get into it sometimes.
Four, three.
So solid, like all the Chinese players are. Just can't find a hole through that backhand side. And then she shows
three,
a variety.
Five.
That is a quality point there. Initially under pressure, and just see how she changed the shape. Put under pressure and then able to transition and attack.
Three,
varying the play. You've got to have total confidence in your game to commit to that win. Sweaterbutt was putting her under the pump with her blocking game, really punching through that she could vary.
Seven, three.
This is the problem. Does Sweaterbutt, building on the earlier point, does she have the power really over the contest to be able to trouble the Olympic champion? Big question mark for me.
8-3.
Opening up a lead of five, the Chinese. Seven of the last 8 points.
4-8. Nine.
Razor sharp. No time really for Sweaterbutt to think in that exchange.
Four, 10-4.
Trying to attack there, not possessing the quality of what we've seen from Chun Meng on a few occasions when she's been in that position in this opening game. 6 game points.
11-4.
Thumps
four.
It through game with aplomb. Chen. Running away with that opening game, the Olympic champion. Game to the good. Chun Meng on Sini Sawetabut. An 11-4 decision. Chun Meng then, a game to the good here in Frankfurt.
Second game, Chen to serve, Lavor.
And to build on it here to begin this second game of a possible five with Sawetabut.
Love one. Let love one. One all.
Such a crafty, knowledgeable player as well. Often have that discussion with my commentary colleague.
One. Two.
Super point again, mid-distance from the table there, so secure. Saying, have this discussion with my commentary colleague you'll be hearing from very shortly for the first time this week. Fraser Riley about this, about Chun Meng. She's able to do.
Three,
extending there,
one.
You've seen 12 of the last 16, 13 in the last 17 now, but discussions around what's her great quality. Her thinking prowess is often his point around it. You think of Ma Long, the cleverest players out there at the table. Makes the case on the women's side, Chun Meng. And I think we saw it in that opening game when she was put under, comparatively under, a little bit of pressure. Doesn't get flustered. Has got all the shots, but also shot selection. The key in many ways for her.
One, five.
And you can have all the shots, but some players sometimes can struggle. They can have too many options. Never get the impression with Chun Meng that she's out of place with that. She generally makes the right decision.
One, two.
And a fabulous point. I mean, Sawetabut's not playing badly here. Giving it everything. Talk about attack, commitment to attack, tries it. But it's not enough. Such is the calibre, the quality of the opponent.
Oh, six, yeah. Two.
Just on the way through, that's that really good punch that, that Sawetabut has got when she can redirect up the line. Yeah, just catches, that's the line of the table there. Maybe a little bit of outside edge of it as well, but quality shot.
7-2.
Beaten for pace there. Yeah, Sawetabut, but very experienced. You know, look at the career she's building. multiple Olympic appearances. Medals continentally, as we've been saying, WTT series play, regular. Very good player. And as the policewoman that she is as well, she just wants to try and bring a bit more order to this contest from her point of view. So it's been Chun Meng laying down the law here.
8-4.
Please, watching this on sofa. I won't be surprised, really, Marlene. You've seen this before. This charge, what she can do.
9-4.
Varies again there, stabbing that in towards the middle. Difficult to receive that.
4-10.
Yeah, oh, the body language, that reaction from Suetta, but says it all. Puffs out the cheeks. What can I do here? I'm playing well.
11-4.
Life at the top table. She knows it. It's an elite competitor who is showcasing it here on the big stage in Frankfurt so far. Chun Meng now two up here on Sotatini Suetta, but again it's 11-4 for the Chinese.
In Frankfurt und vielleicht können wir gleich dann noch mal kurz beide Spielerinnen anfeuern, wenn es zurück hier geht an den Tisch.
Look at the current top 10 in the ITTF table tennis world rankings. Chun Meng has been a world number one before. Challenge for her, actually, for everyone right now, is how to stop Xia Xia. I mean, look at this lead, verging on the ridiculous. 4,000 points right now, but firmly in there at number two, which just, she's so consistent. The point that I'm making is, this week, can she snap the title drought? I think that'll be a big motivation for her, Chun Meng, as well as trying to bridge the gap to Xia Xia, as they're all trying to do.
Time.
Und jetzt beide noch mal pushen. Applaus für die Spielerin.
Third game, Zabetta Butt to serve, Lavaux.
Third game here to begin of a possible five. Chun Meng, two up on this lady here, Sini Suetta, but we'll begin game three.
Lavaux, one.
Needs that tomahawk immediately. Nothing doing there for Suetta, but.
One,
all. Yeah, I just think here, just a pushing game, not quite up to it. Pushes deep there. It was kind of half long in a sense. Was neither short. She went deeper. Didn't really get it right that time.
Oh. 2-1.
Easy does it. Opening up the table, up the angle, Suetta, but she's torched for it. That's the reach of explosive movement, dynamic movement of Chun Meng.
1-3.
Good service there, reading the spin. Threw in that faster, longer at the top.
2-3.
The towel break, first of game three then, and looking to be a familiar story here. Chun opening up a lead. So steady, so solid, drawing the error.
Let 4, 2. Five, two.
Yeah, she's called the timeout as much as anything here.
Timeout.
Not Maracala, the coach there, Soweta, but just needing a moment here.
Mit der heißen Phase in Satz Nummer 3.
Have a look at this here. The roll of honour, as we call it here, for the winners of WTT Series events. I mean, it's quite a cast, isn't it, as you roll through this. But look at this. There's no Chun Mun in the season. Multiple finals, but no title. And again, that's the target, I think, this week. She's playing well enough to do it. But her problem, as I said earlier, there's a lot of Sha-Sha in there. Hina Hayata, multiple titles as well, be a threat this week. But no Chun Mun, last title, the Singapore Smash 2022.
5-2.
Looking good here.
2-6.
Struggles to get a read on the receive, isn't she there? Saw the fast long topspin serve as well that went
three,
popped up in there. That was just loaded. Backspin. That's why it's into the net there.
Seven.
Yeah, mid distance. Nothing's troubling her. Soweta, but try as she might. Just very, very little that she can hurt the Chinese with here. Either mid distance where she troubles most players. Chun, no issues.
Let 7-3.
This has been a big part of why she's in this commanding lead. Success on serve, 78%, and Soweta, but struggling there, only around a third of the points. She's won off her own ball.
Seven, four.
Rare error.
Four, eight.
Too steady. Seen it a few times, Soweta, but has tried to go out wide to her forehand, and she's just there so easily. Her footwork's so good. It's got good range as well, pretty good levers, Chun Mun. Hard to get her an error out of the middle, wide as well. She's good there, good everywhere.
4-9.
And she's looking good again. We talk about the title drought, but I mean, the flip side to that, I'd say, is, you know, look at the finals, all the consistent performances in that time. Her win rate against non-Chinese players.
10-4.
Is other than her compatriots, is around 90-95%. I'm going to get another one here by the looks of it. Six match points.
10-5.
That'll do nicely. Game. Job done. Net. Business as usual for Chun Mun, the Olympic champion here. Opens the week in Frankfurt with a matter-of-fact win over a very good player in Sufati Soweta, but the Thai, who just couldn't get into that. She's not the first, she won't be the last to lose 3-0 to Chun Mun. 11-4, 11-4, 11-5. The second seed here through to the round of 16 at a canter. This is how it finished. In the end here, these highlights. She'd be very pleased with that. We've only got the best here. Suetabud, a top player. If you're slightly off it, she could have taken advantage, but that just wasn't the case. Dominating behind serve, varying the play, mid-distance, changes of shape, of height, everything really. And putting together some good winning streaks as well. 18 minutes, that was all for Chen Mun. I'm sure she'll get straight to the practice table as well to build up to her next encounter after that. Next up, the Evergreens. We'll go head-to-head here. Timo Boll, can you imagine this? 42 years of age, the legend on home soil here. The first WTT Series event in Germany to take on the former world championship medalist, Lee Sang-soo of Korea Republic. One of the most well-known financial districts in the world here. You have Deutsche Bank's Twin Towers around as well, popularly called Debit and Credit, 155 meters tall. Those beautiful windows as well, but this is a financial hub, and it's Sabina Winter who's profited so far here. First match of the week, the German on home soil. Tough one for her as a wild card against a top 40 player in Linda Bergström of Sweden, but the German got the mix, got the balance just right. Really cashing in that contest to reel off a 3-0 victory over the Swede and make the round of 16 here in Frankfurt. That was how it looked in the end. 21 minutes for Winter, who really did well in the midsections of those games, opened up advantages as well. You can see a 5-point winning streak, her best, and dominating behind her serve as well. She was one of the winners, followed on by a double success for the Chinese, Wang Chuqin, 3-0 over the rising star Gao Zhengrui, and then just now the Olympic champion Chen Meng brushing aside to Susini Sawetabut of Thailand, again by 3-0 scoreline. In terms of the second half, the matches just keep on coming in quality. Later, Lim Jong-hoon as well, always dependable from Korea Republic against Australia's Nicholas Lum. Lim's compatriot Shin Yubin against the European standout for so long, Fu Yu. And this one that we're building up to as well, Lee Sang-soo against Timo Boll, coming up very soon as well. Let's dip in for some of the razzmatazz, though, of world table tennis here now.
Frankfurt, make some noise for the German Mr. Table Tennis, the German legend, Timo Boll!
The 6-times bronze and silver medalist at the World Champions from the Republic of Korea, Lee Sang-soo!
Well, thank you, Guy. Two grizzled veterans entering the Infinity Arena now for the fourth match of the day. Lee Sang-soo versus Timo Boll. Fraser Riley here taking over commentary for you. And, well, this one has magic written all over it. Let's take a look at the tail of the table. It's been a hat-trick of wins for Timo Magic Boll, aging like fine wine, 42 years of age, 20 European Table Tennis Championship gold medals, he's won the World Cup twice, been ranked as high as one on the planet back in 2018 and before that as well. This man just sees off generation after generation of threats. Here is Rebecca Berfeld, our head official, who will be tossing the coin to determine the server and receiver at the start of this match. Lee Sang-soo is going to be nibbling at the ankles here of Boll. He is desperate for his first win against him. A warm embrace here.
Toss, black or red? Red for Boll, black for Lee. Red for Boll, receive.
Timo Boll, the flag bearer of Germany at the 2016 Olympic Games in Rio, chooses to receive at the start of this match. That will mean if it goes to 9-all in the deciding fifth game, he would have the serves. That's why he's chosen to give it away there. The warm-up begins here in this men's singles round of 32 match. It's the 33-year-old Lee Sang-soo here on screen, the bronze medalist at the 2017 World Championships, which was actually here in Germany as well, not so far away in Dusseldorf. That was the first time I ever watched pro table tennis live, and well, it's funny how things have come full circle, and what a pleasure it is to be commentating these guys here now. Timo Boll has won 23 events, with a 77 career win record, full of tricks, full of unpredictability, but he is a master of spin craft, always looking to change, and it's the rotation and the location is near perfect with respect to his shot selection. You can see what's up for grabs. 30k will go to the winner of singles. Table tennis, one of the sports that's fair. Same for women as well. 30,000 on offer for the ladies too. And of course, the further you go, the more cash to the bank. 1,000 ranking points, it's worth mentioning as well, will be awarded to the winner. So we could see some monumental changes here in the world rankings of this hard-waiting event. Well, they can't help but smile. A living legend here about to take to the stage. Here he is. Be receiving at the start of this match against Lee Sang-soo of Korea.
First game, lead to serve, love all.
Lee Sang-soo pendulum serve comes into action here, and it's a solid third ball flick. So strong over the table, Lee Sang-soo. Overcuts that forehand. Good pressure from Bolt. Rolling it over. Not someone who likes to play the power flick ball. Solid in the touch play, and of course the counter. So good.
There.
It was curtains. Beautifully played. Deja vu.
1-3.
Lee Sang-soo's going to have to be careful there. Timo Boll is such a subtle server. The best servers in the world come in with the exact identical service motion.
2-3.
That was electric from Lee. Just like Timo Boll, he's been able to beat Ma Long before. Testament to the quality that he poses.
3-3.
We're seeing a lot of third ball kills here so far. It's not even a bad receive. That's not even long there from Bolt. But Lee Sang-soo comes over the top of it, lunges in. And they split the points at the first tile break. Ball now going for the reverse pendulum serve. The net cord exposing the tactic. Will he do it again? Oh, well. It's gorgeous control there from Timo, but Lee pulling a blinder out of his pocket. You let the ball drop a little bit more there to play with more arc from mid-distance. Sensible choice, not easy to do.
Let. 3-4. 5-3.
Despite the head-to-head being 3-0 to Boll, the last time they played was a few years ago. Jusei Hyuk there, the legendary defender, and Jorg Woskop in the corner for Timo. But as I was saying, two of their three encounters have gone to the deciding game.
5-4.
So it is still close between them. That's one that Lee Sang-soo would have loved to have made and would have expected himself to have made.
4-6.
Helped by the net there. Has a cushion of two. Serves back with Timo Boll. Shot block from Boll.
5-6.
The hand skill of Timo. I mean, we've seen the hand switches against players like Ma Long. The fanning forehands we saw against Liang at the China Open. You know, he just got it all, Timo. Such a talent.
7-5.
Has quite an unusual style, Timo. But the fundamentals are there. You know, you don't see so many players where you say, they've got a similar forehand to Boll, you know. Something different about it, but he keeps the bat very high, which allows him to spin very directly. And the posture's low, which gives him more awareness around the net area.
8-5.
Beautiful from Lee Sang-soo there. Sweeping that right leg back, which helps him transition his weight forwards through those slower rollovers from Timo, and then pins the middle of the German. 8-8. Oh my word, Boll. That's just what you got to expect, really. It's not over till it's over. Timo showing his flair. Look at that lunging chop. Lee Sang-soo was flabbergasted there before it was even over. Still was high. felt obliged to attack it, Lee, but maybe didn't need to try and go for such a angle.
6-9.
You're never really safe against Timo. ...2003 World Championship finalist, Chuse-hyuk. Hey.
10-6.
Try and help Lee Sang-soo in the second game, regardless of the outcome. There's Rostock there, trying to egg on Timo, but it's 4 game points to the Korean. And what a way to finish it.
6.
Against the momentum of the German legend. Gets off to a flying start here, Lee Sang-soo. Can he keep up this ante? 1-0 in this best of five. Stay tuned for game number two there. So world number 62 looks in a bit of trouble. Feels strange seeing him down there, but looking to try and get back up as a host-nominated wildcard, Timo. Let's see what happens next. Lee Sang-soo here looking to throw a spanner
second
in
game,
the works.
Ball to serve, love all.
Of the morale of the German fans here. Home favourite, Timo Boll beginning game two with the serves.
Love
that
one.
It's predatory from Lee. Nearly 10 years younger, but still 33 years old, older than most in the top 32.
One all.
Or should I say the 32 that are here? We have some big names absent due to some continental events that are happening.
One, two.
Got a race to the finals on. Going to be in Qatar for the men's and Nagoya for the women's. That'll be the top 16 in the world. Even more exclusive than this event, but all to play for. Here we see at the bottom of our screens who's qualified and who's in the running.
3-2.
Unlikely to see a ball there. I mean, we saw in Lanzhou him returning to a WTT Series event for the first time in over a year. Less used to this kind of scenery than Lee Sang-soo, even though we're in Germany, here for the champions. Jang Woo-jin, Korea's number one, looking like he's going to make it. Wow.
2-5.
Timo Boll. Again with that chop block, turning topspin into backspin. Coming round the side from above and down onto the ball.
Hey, hey, hey. Ah. 5-3.
Be a good time to book your tickets. It's not so long away now. There's the cutoff of the top 16.
Sjöberg
of Sweden. Still there, Freitas winning his first WTT title this season. Truls Morgaard, this is a massive match for him tonight against Fan Zhendong, the world number one. A back to this. It's a better game here from Timo. Playing with a lot more spin. I mean, he always plays with spin, but here, really trying to get more dwell on his top spins. Oh.
5-6.
Paid the price there, Timo, for the step around. Kind of has to be a finisher. Because of how you're leaving the wide forehand exposed with that. Even though he's got one of the best backhands ever, ball, still feels like he can impose himself more with the forehand from there.
7-5.
But he keeps the cushion of two. Had time on that ball, Lee, but it's so arcy, so spinny, tough to calibrate the counter. Second tile break, ball ahead by two. Good guide flick there from Lee. Ball trying to do the reverse pendulum. Fairly floaty into the forehand to get a weaker receive, but good placement on it there from Lee Sang-soo. Not to be that time. Ball played a slower shot, but with more spin. Fizzing. And Sang-soo can't contain it with the closed racket angle. Oh, well.
Nine.
Held by the edge. The set piece there was on for Lee Sang-soo on the step over, but ball made a really nice angle off the wide one.
9-7.
Striking the ball in the iron's hot. Transferring his energy, taking the ball out in front. Planting the feet to get in position first. You cannot build a house on sand. And that was a real strong base. Great balance from Timo, and it's 3 game points. So much spin from the distance. Trademark ball. Still shining bright here. And aren't the German fans gassed about it? Bit of spice into the mix here. But 1-1, stay tuned for the third game. This really is anyone's, I feel. Who've been the arrowhead of their teams for so long, really. Clashing in the modern era of table tennis under the bright lights of WTT. Could it be Lee Sang-soo's day? He's never beaten ball before.
Third game, Lee to serve, love all.
Definitely on the cards. The ball looking to close the deck.
Love one.
The momentum with him. I wouldn't say he's as powerful as Lee Sang-soo ball, but it's how he changes the rhythm. Just genius, isn't it, really? There, Lee Sang-soo taking full advantage of the slower balls. Ball asking him to make pace of his own, and that's exactly what he did with that compact backhand. We talked about Fan Jendong versus Truls Moregard. To many, that's going to be the match of the day. Closing off day one, and the winner of this match will play the winner of that, just for some context. Wow.
Two all.
Great containing there from Sang-su. Extending more on that final one off a ball that was slightly more shallow on the table from Timo.
Three, two.
This is why, obviously it depends on where your opponent is stood, but in general, if your opponent's quite close to the table, trying to spin deep is better. Because if it's shallow, it's easier for them to come in over the top of it. If it's deep, they've got to really kind of make space for it, which is not easy to do in a sport where you're given so little time.
Left. Three all. Three, four.
Bit of an escape there. It's a ball that Timo will make at least 8, 9, and 10.
Five, three.
But when you add pressure into the equation, you'll see a lot more upsets than what you might in training. Nothing more irregular than a match. Great defense from Lee Sang-su. Tried to fire with the backhand to give himself, he felt, to be more of a chance. Timo knows if he keeps pinning that backhand, less likely to have an issue. Sang-su's going to be more comfortable to counter away from the table with the forehand.
Yeah! 4-6.
Lovely shape of that backhand though, that. Nice touch. Plays the backhand from the middle. Steps into it.
Bouncer.
Short serve from Timo Boll. Wow. Look how fast the contact was. Could be what fooled Lee Sang-su there. Oh.
7-5.
It caught the edge. Timo thought he had it. Nothing he could have done about that, the legend from Germany. And Lee Sang-su keeps a cushion of two. Still great reactions from the Korean there to even get back on ball.
Eight, five.
Just a bit more physical, isn't he, Lee Sang-su? Ball's kept himself in tremendous shape. But Lee can see in his base. Massive quads. With his aura ring there to track sleep and recovery. Don't sleep on Timo there either. You are not safe until the point is literally over. You have no time to admire your own shot. Feeding off the pace of Lee Sang-su there. Brilliant defense from Timo Boll. And a timeout called accordingly from Joo Se-hyuk. Getting too close for comfort here.
Österreich auf die ganz, ganz heiße Phase in Satz Nummer 3. Und da brauchen wir wirklich jeden auf der Tribüne.
The LaSalle Sports Arena is going to be home to the world's best once more, but this time for the WTT Finals. On screen there, you can see the top four, Ma Long, Fan Jendong, Wang Chuqin, and the thrill from Brazil, Hugo Calderano. You saw the graphic earlier. You can, of course, head over to WTT's website to check the current rankings. Breathing down the neck of Lee Sang-soo, Timo Boll with a serve to come here. It's a great flick. Boll, being the perfectionist that he is, won't be too happy with the serve. Definitely invited that receive of Lee. And he couldn't recover out quick enough. Two away from sealing the deal here, Lee Sang-soo. Good length. Got some indecision out of the Korean there. No spin on the serve, but look how Timo puts his forefinger quite high on the bat to stabilise the racket. One of his other unique features.
Oh.
See you later, alligator, says Lee Sang-soo. Again, not so much spin on the serve. Stamps the foot to mask the indication of spin. And then a textbook put away. Had to stay composed with all that scoreboard pressure. Two game points. Can he take it on the receive? Yes, he can.
11-8.
It's a great touch. But still, guarded optimism from Lee Sang-soo. He understands the threat that Boll poses, but he is one game away from getting his first ever victory against the 42-year-old wizard. Stay tuned because we've got more in store with game number 4.
Und noch ein Hinweis generell für heute und für die nächsten Tage. Bitte nach dem Spiel nicht in den Innenbereich reingehen, sondern auf den Sitzen bleiben. Ich klar, man will gerne mal Instanz haben, will mal mit dem Kunst sprechen, vielleicht ein Autogramm holen, zählt nicht machen, aber dafür haben wir hier auch immer Autogrammstunden vorne am Fanpavillon, wo man genau das machen kann. Also bitte da ein bisschen zurückbleiben und die Spieler erstmal in Ruhe lassen. Aber jetzt geht es erstmal weiter. Mit dem Spiel jetzt nochmal einen großen Applaus für Timo Boll vor dem Spiel.
Time.
Well, he's made bigger comebacks than this, Timo. That match against Lin Gaoyuan in Liège for the World Cup definitely rings a couple of bells, but here, a different type of test against Lee Sang-soo, who is one away from ending the run at the first hurdle.
Fourth game, Boll to serve, love all.
One. Just obliterates it, Lee Sang-soo. Watch the top level of table tennis, because what it helps you realise, like a lot of racket sports, and sports in general, is power doesn't come from the length of the contact. It's all about the acceleration. In table tennis, you've barely got any time, so it's got to be short and sharp. And look at that. Taking the words out of my mouth there, Lee Sang-soo. And taking the wind out of Boll's sails. It's a flawless start for the Korean here in game number 4. He's in hot water. Can he swim to shore with the help of Roskopf? This is not an easy situation
think Ball doesn't want to match Sangsu pace for pace. She's got to come from more of that spin craft that we talked about earlier. Roskopf, a left-handed legend of Germany in his own right, a former world doubles champion, knows Timo Boll's game out the back of his hand. How can Boll make Lee Sang-Soo uncomfortable with his placement and spin variation? I think the reverse pendulum serve into Lee Sang-Soo's middle and forehand could be a good recipe for success. But here the Korean has the serve at 3-0 up. And again, it's just basically no trouble. It's going to eat that up like breakfast, lunch and dinner, Lee Sang-Soo. Seven of the last eight. Better from Boll that. Than one of those shots hit the top edge of his racket, but still. Taking the ball at the peak of the bounce, and they're fading that one. Yeah, that was the one I think that hit the top edge. Kind of made the ball waver in the air.
Whoa! Oh. 5-1.
Another scorcher from Lee Sang-Soo, who is just painting the table, spraying it around. Too hot to handle. Five one up here.
Five.
Better from Timo. Testing Lee Sang-Soo's footwork. From forehand into middle, transitioning from right to left. When you practice that kind of Japanese footwork exercise, all the players in the top level do it. The 3-point forehands. Ooh.
3-5.
I saw one that doesn't actually wound Boll there, physically or in terms of the scoreboard. Feels like he could be creeping back into this one, Timo. Let himself down a couple of times with the service. But again, Lee Sang-Soo can make a decent serve look god-awful with how he sniffs that half long.
Oh. 7-3.
It's a kick in the shin. A German player in every session here in the first day of action, but still this would be a wounding loss. But this backhand has been, honestly, stunning. Running out of superlatives for it. But it was all set up by the forehand into the middle of Boll. Beware of the Lee Sang-Soo backhand. Going to find it tougher to belt a spinnier, slower ball, Lee Sang-Soo. The beauty of playing a slower ball as well is that it can make your opponent overthink their shot. The ball kind of dangles in the air. Trying to get behind him here.
4-9.
But he's had an answer to almost everything here, Lee Sang-Soo. This could be a staple win.
Wow.
It's a real shame for Timo and the Deutsche Tischtennis fans, but Lee Sang-Soo's been impeccable. And he stamps his authority with a sweeping forearm there.
Lead.
Take a bow. In more ways than one, respect shown in the end to Timo Boll. But Lee Sang-Soo was so well prepared. And well, that finish, as good as it was, didn't tell half the story. He beats Timo Boll for the first time in his career. Two veterans clashing here in the round of 32. No easy way through in this draw.
and to the despair of the German fans, Timo Boll is heading home. Home-nominated wildcard entry due to inactivity down at 62 in the world. Well, everybody loves Timo Boll. It's never easy seeing him lose, but you've got to say, a deserved victor in the end there. More than 11 points between them. You can see the service win percentage as well. Lee Sang-soo is very effective with his pendulum. Boll really tried to vary it, but Lee was just hunting for that attacking opportunity and got it done in just under half an hour. Up next, we have Fu Yu of Portugal, the high-toss traditional penholder, facing up against the youngest player in the world's top 10, Shin Yubin of Korea. Guy McCree will be taking over lead commentary up next.
Welcome back here to the Infinity Arena, building up to our next encounter, round of 32 action here at the WTT Champions Frankfurt. Disappointment for the home fans just now. Timo Boll going out at the first time of asking, but credit to Lee Sang-soo for that performance, his first win over Boll in their careers. And Lim Jong-hoon involved later. But let's get now to the introductions ahead of our latest women's match.
2016 from Portugal, Fu Yu. Here is the world's number 8 from the Republic of Korea. Welcome, Shin Yubin.
One of the shining stars of the sport right now, Shin Yubin, the youngest member of the world's top 10 right now at a career high rank, and looking to lay a marker down here as well. Clash of the generations here. Never get tired of that storyline. And here's another example of it. There's the 19-year-old takes on the 44-year-old Fu Yu of Portugal over a best-of-five game encounter. First to 11 points, a two-point clear winning margin is always needed to take each game. Taylor the table. Not surprisingly, really, it's a first meeting in a sense. Shin Yubin has been around a little while, but it's been a meteoric rise in other senses. You look at that, at a career-high rank. Fu has been top 15 in the world, has won the European Games gold medal a few years ago, been a runner-up in the European Championships back in 2016. Very experienced and a very awkward opponent, always. Anya Giersdorf, our umpire for this one. Midway through the afternoon here in Frankfurt. Lovely buzz around the arena. Real excitement, knowledge. I was just between matches actually wandering around, chatting to a couple of spectators. They're so excited about this here. But it's two-way, isn't it, really? It's also the knowledge of the sport in this Please. Country.
You have red or black? Red for she, black for you. Black wins. Service for full side. Perfect.
They're winning the coin toss. We'll serve first here, the pen holder.
The silver medal at the European Championships 2016. And then here she also...
Guy McCree alongside Fraser Riley. First time this week teaming up here. Fraser, pleasure to work with you as always. What about this one? First up, the clash of the generations here. They're checking out each other's equipment. We've got to get to that, haven't we? Because Fuyu is awkward to play against.
Absolutely. Great to be alongside you once more, Guy. And yeah, clash of generations and a clash of styles. A traditional penhole player, Fuyu of Portugal, 44 years of age, a very tricky customer who is always looking to switch her opponent around. Shin Yubin is very capable of doing that.
You commentate, obviously we work together, you commentate a lot of the events. Shin Yubin, mentioned youngest in the world's top 10. I mean, it, ridiculous talent, isn't she, what she's doing already at 19 years of age?
Yeah, she is the scarlet of Team Korea. So explosive, very powerful, fantastic striking ability. We see that in the mixed doubles as well alongside Lim Jong-hoon. Here you can see the fan vote heavily favouring her.
Yeah, she's very popular as well. That's evidenced in this. And if you want to give Fuyu some love here, the way to do it, worldtabletennis.com. Sign up and cast your vote there. But Shin, yeah, it's predictable. She's one of the most popular players. You look around the social media, absolute star. But as we've been saying, very awkward opponent for her first up here. This elite equipment that they've got here. We take the fans through it, don't we, as well. The players, the flooring as well. Neo flooring. They're the best equipment for the best in the sport that we've got here this week. Fitting, really. So round of 32 action continuing here in Frankfurt.
First game, food to serve. Level.
See how this clash of generations and of styles goes here. Best of five. It'll be interesting, in addition to all of that, we talked about in the knockout phrase, in terms of Lanjo as well, and just, you know, in terms of how Shin Yubin finished that event, drawing from the doubles, just how fit she is here as well. Had a little bit of time to recover and get ready for this huge event.
Recovery is a key word. It's equally as important as how active you are in preparing. She had issues with her back, which is why she had to withdraw from the women's doubles final in Lanzhou, China's first ever star contender. But yeah, I'd say her striking is definitely better than her movement. You see some players that are very fast but can't quite hit the ball as hard. Shin Yubin's penetrating ability is very good. She can hit through most players. But the placement is going to be unpredictable coming from the other end.
One, three.
Fuyu's strength is her weakness. That's how she tries to cover it up. Laterally, you won't see her chasing forehands, going for dive shots, lobbing. She's a table hugger because of the stylistic limitation that she has.
but she's very, very good. As you say, it's also, you could say, the weaker spot is also a strength. I get where you're coming from on that.
Yeah, because she can't move as fast, she wants to do that first to the opponent.
4-2.
This is the reason why the modern penhold grip was invented, to add the reverse penhold backhand. And it's funny, isn't it? You don't see traditional penholders in the men's top level, only the women's, with Shan Shanar, Fu Yu, and of course, yeah, a couple more in there, like Nisha Lian.
Oh,
3-5.
I mean, you fancied the Portuguese's chances there. Not in the end.
Yeah. Shin adapting well. Playing the parallel off the parallel switch. Clever to go against the momentum of Fu Yu there.
4-5.
This is the thing about penholders though, Guy. Some of the best servers ever, penhold players. You can have a lot of flexibility with that grip, especially on the forehand.
4-5.
Yeah, it's part of what makes this Portuguese so tricky to play against, those high toss serves.
How
dynamic the footwork was there from Shin. Snare that point. Had to be.
If she can get past the serve-receive aspect that Fu Yu brings, then I fancy Shin's chances. But there was a big question mark on her receivability against that high toss, because it is one of the best in the world.
7-4.
But look at that pivot. In the blink of an eye, she turns. And it's impending doom. Look at that serve. If it's any lower, it's a net. Cord there. Perfect serve coming in from the shovel.
5-7.
To a second towel break here. No, we just highlight it because you're so used to so many matchups, of course, just being smooth. Robert's shake hand attack versus shake hand attack, and it's just Francisco there, coach here for Fu.
And
we highlight it because it is tricky and it's awkward, and it is interesting. Again, we were around the here yesterday watching the players, and when you've got an awkward opponent first up, Fraser, what you do, and you had Juhasiuk practicing the penhold grip, wasn't he?
7-4.
On this table to try and get Shin used to it.
Yeah, Juhasiuk, obviously a chopper in his heyday, trying to make Shin Yubin more accustomed. Because it can be quite distracting as well. Because you've got to pay attention to the contact, so playing against someone with a different grip could distract you if you're not 100% focused on the ball itself.
8-7.
That was a massive point there. To kind of diffuse the accumulated momentum of the Portuguese penholder.
8-0.
She's never really comfortable, is she, Shin Yubin? Because Fu Yu is just so good at changing the pace. Shin Yubin was trying to get a caught into the crossover straight from the serve. But she made a good enough compound movement there.
8-0.
Solid flick and then goes into the middle. Wasn't right into the pocket, but still suffocated the attack. Fu Yu enough to win the point.
10-8.
And that's a kick in the shin.
You could put it that way. That's a tough one for Fu to take there. Such a tight opening game. And the error gives Shin here a couple of game points.
Shin will feel a bit of extra pressure on her serve because she knows how good the server is on the other end. However, she doesn't want to rush, doesn't want to tense.
Oh.
10. Oh.
Takes that one apart. Both game points saved by Fu.
This is something that comes with experience. You read it like a picture book, like there was nothing to read.
11, 10.
Now over the table, brings up another game point. Good response. One of her many qualities is mentally how good she is at responding.
Still had a bit to do after the net cord there.
Two clear point winning margin needed, of course, from 10 all, and Shin's got the chance to do that now.
11.
Oh. Glances that one away.
A lot of these youngsters, they want pace to feed off. They want it fast, 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 fast. And Fu is not giving Shin that.
11, 12.
And that's why she's making some, in inverted commas, uncharacteristic errors. Even though that looks like an unforced error, that could be actually forced.
I was about to say, Fraser, I mean, it's that fine line, really. I tend to where you're going, I think that's forced because of the quality
11,
of the
12.
Ball, the variety of the ball.
She's putting it into that temptation zone of the crossover, of the step around section.
12.
This time, and just to generate enough pace into the middle.
Great bit of composure there from the youngster. It's amazing, but tough to watch. It's just the tension, you can hear a pin drop.
Yeah, that's a great comment there. Just the feeling, the atmosphere in the Infinity Arena, how it varies match to match because of what we're watching, privileged to watch.
13, 12.
Yeah, the crowd here, very knowledgeable. The German team national championships are held here. Not in the Infinity Arena, but in the building, it's general here. And German table tennis fans in general, very knowledgeable. Recognise how tight this opening game is, still is.
And why?
Yeah. Fourth game point for Shin.
14,
this one's
12.
Taken, and yeah, the raising of the fist there knows the importance of that. How hard she had to work to take it, Shin. But it is the teenager who strikes first here. On a fourth game point opportunity, Fu had one, but it's Shin who snares the opener. 14-12. That was quite a tense opening game there to this one. The matches are getting a little bit tighter now as well as we go on. I know we started off with a raft of 3-0 score lines, but it was never going to continue that way. We've got the best of the best here.
Shin to serve.
This week. You know, the pressure around as well when you're in a straight knockout against, in the main, fellow top 30 players as well. It's really tough. Level of competition in the intensity.
One love.
It so often is a battle of styles. And against a player like Fu Yu, as a youngster with a more modern style, more recommended style on average, it's usually a more mental challenge than physical.
One all.
These pros, they can play 7-8 hours a day, and they do on a day-to-day basis. But the anxiety that can come about as a result of playing against a tricky customer with a unique style like Fu Yu can often be underestimated. As a youngster myself, playing in like the local leagues, trying to improve, I hate playing against the players with more unusual styles.
Let. One all.
Wow, look at that serve.
One.
The way it kind of bent into the body of Shin with the side spin there. Must be a nightmare to receive.
Two all.
Chase is there, but got that away well.
All came from that switch. Got a bit of net luck, albeit, but still came across that winner to guide the ball out wide. Effortless there from the sensei.
Three, all.
Through to the towel break here. Ask you, Fraser, actually, where you rate Fuyu's serves overall in the women's game in terms of difficulty to receive, because you still sense Shin is grappling with that.
Three,
and well
four.
There to get into the rally, get out of the serve receive, just with that high toss, with the grip, with the pips as well.
I'd say her serves the top five in the game,
yeah.
Top five in the world.
Yeah.
Five, three.
And you can sometimes see by the fact that she can't really play the longer rallies as often, that she doesn't want to, how much emphasis there is on finishing the point straight from the serve. Mm-hmm. And you see that as well with France's Yuen Jianan. With her high toss as well, it's just so spinny.
Five, four.
Not a lot of attackers like to serve with too much spin. Because the quality of receive is so good, you might get more spin coming back to deal with on your third ball. Be surprised how often you see pros serve with basically no spin, but they'll do everything to try and make it seem otherwise.
Four, six.
One difference maker I've noticed so far that's helped Shin turn this around has been her forehand prowess, her ability to play those parallels.
Yep.
Trying to pin the backhand of Fu Yu.
Yeah, I think it's a big area where she's improved, really, why the rankings continue to rise. She's out there.
Six.
Very, very strong and direct. She's always, you know, kind of bounced around that wide base and everything else and had those qualities, but she can hit through much more powerfully now.
Left.
Didn't work out there, but we're still leading by one here, midway through the second game. Korea Republic standout. Oh, and that, wow, that was interesting. Kind of baited Fu there in the middle of the table. I'm not sure she quite meant it like that, but no. You could see the intent.
Yeah. Well, it was a shocking receive, but it played into the twist of the tail, didn't it?
Yeah. I think she was going, but obviously a lot tighter to the net than she managed. Maybe it surprised Fu, I don't know.
You barely ever prepare for those to come back, you know?
8-5.
Just surreal reactions, and it was very clutch with the scoreline. Could have a little bit of scar power. Fu Yu is not one to forgive herself too quickly, let's just say that. So, be surprised to see her shake that one off straight away.
6-8.
She does have a kind of come on now, let's get on with it aura about her. Ooh.
7-8.
What a time to get an edge.
Yeah, gets her back into things. Massive point coming up here.
Nine, 7.
This is the thing as well about Shin, 19-year-old, and of course winning titles as she's done a couple this season. Contender Lagos, contender Lima as well. That gives you the confidence in these situations to know that you can do it. So the first game was very tight. The second game's gone that way as well, and still it's a lead of two.
10-7.
Game points, very efficient in the key moments.
11-7.
There we go then. Four in a row there. And two game lead now for Shin Yubin. Looking good here. The top 10 star. For you with plenty to think about. Two down here in the best of five as Shin takes the second. 11 points to 7. The movers and shakers, as we call them, in the past 12 months. Interesting the fact that she's 8 in the world, has gone up 26 spots. So often say, don't we, the fact that as you go up the rankings, you try and halve your ranking. The expression, and that gets, obviously gets more difficult as you go up the rankings. But look at the movement in the past 12 months alone. They're firmly into the top 10 now.
Monumental. She's been absolutely cleaning up on the contender scene. Now it's a question of how she gets on against the players who are above her, the Chinese national team players. A coach in the corner here, Cho Won Rae, very solid player, represented the Republic of Korea. And actually beat Fan Zhendong. So he knows exactly what to do. It's just a case of how Shin Yubin executes. She cannot afford to become complacent here, though. Every point will feel like an uphill battle against a player
third game.
Like Fu Yu.
You to serve. Love all. Love one.
Quality received to begin game three here. A game that Fu Yu has to win to keep this alive. The best of five, Shin Yubin has underlined her star quality so far.
Two, love.
This is the thing. This is why we call it a stylistic limitation now in the modern era, because how much can you really impose yourself from your backhand side?
Six of the last 8 points. That's, of course, the run to win game two, and now the start to three.
Oh,
two,
that's some great coverage from Shin, but Fu right there that time.
It's gorgeous. She has to switch Shin as soon as possible to open up the table for herself, to open up her options. Doesn't want to get into these backhand-to-backhand rallies. Doesn't want to be chasing a switch herself.
2-0.
This is not over yet. It'd be a fool to be confident in saying Shin will wrap this up 3-0. I'm sure Fuyu has another trick up her sleeve.
2-3.
I've been very impressed with how the youngster has dealt with this player so far.
Oh, back edge, yeah?
4-2.
Yeah. By a whisker.
That will hurt Fu as well. The point she was dictating. Right, the towel break. It's interesting you say about the draw, should she come through? She's in the section, quarter of the draw. That's Shin Yubine's. They both are. To say that, because this isn't over, but it is Sha Sha's section of the draw. So looking ahead, you know, the point you were making before, quarterfinal opponent, if you take it to the next level, well, she might have to beat the very best there to do that. But that's all to come. That's a few days away.
If you come in to an event like this hoping for a decent matchup, you will lose in the first round, regardless of who you play. You have to play to win. You can't play not to lose. And that's one of the key things to becoming a top professional player. Sabina Winter of Germany awaits the winner of this one in the round of 16.
Timeout's been used here now.
Time.
Francisco there with Fu Yu, who knows, actually, Fu knows Germany very well, if you think about it. Played here in since the German League, Berlin East Side Club for many years. Top team that has been, won the ETTU, the Champions League, on a number of occasions. She's been a part of that. Shan Xiana, many others. Georgina Potter. A lot of them have played for that outfit over the years.
5-3-5.
It's that little twiddle, little switch, and too much for Shin.
3-6.
What
six.
Phrase that she hasn't done, Fu? Just wondering, Seth Rice, hasn't got runs of points together, if you think of her at her best. Been moments, but Shin's been very good at responding, you know, not letting those streaks to build.
And that again boils down to the fact that I'd say the majority of Fu Yu's game is based on the serve, unlike a more open rally player like Shin Yubin. And because Shin's been so good on the receive, haven't been able to see that kind of traditional quality of the Portuguese player shine through as often.
7-4.
There's that shovel again. Coming around the side of the ball. Very tough to identify what spins on it.
4-8.
This is a really smart performance from Shin. I kind of forget where she's at. I mean, you know, we work together in world table tennis events. I mean, if you think about the advent of world table tennis, Shin Yubin coincides with that, with the revolution of the sport, in a way, as the star to take the game forward.
4-9.
Just eases that away as well. And she's so popular and in some ways actually so pragmatic about her game as well.
Korea in a very good place with Ju Chun Hui, Shin Yubin, Kim Nayeon, and a couple of others.
They're all lining up towards Busan, aren't they? And February.
Oh, that would be a treat.
Home World Championships, Team World Championships in February in Korea Republic. Shin to star there, I'm sure.
10-5.
She's starring here on this big stage. Five match points now.
Heavy push there. Takes a lot to rev up the back of that ball to counter out the backspin.
7-10. Timeout.
That's what we haven't seen a lot of there, actually, unreturned. Now the timeout coming from Cho. Two match points gone. Three to go.
Nochmal, wie gesagt, einfach nochmal runterkommen. Noch mal kurz überlegen, was mache ich beim nächsten Rückschlag, was habe ich vor, wo spiele ich die Gegnerin an, wie will ich diesen letzten Punkt machen?
We've got a huge event coming up, of course, in the middle of December. The WTT Finals Women, Nagoya in Japan. And interesting in terms of our matchup here, because Shin Yubin is going to be joining these other big stars, Chen Meng, Sun Ying Sha, Hina Hayata, Wang Manyu. In terms of the fact she's already qualified, but there are spots still to be filled at the moment. There are nine women have qualified, but it's the top 16. So there's seven spots still to be filled there. But it's going to be a fantastic event. Ticket sales apparently extremely good. Kind of expect that with that event, and of course the state of the sport women's game in Japan.
Time.
Time out vorbei mit jedem Ball kann diese Partie jetzt vorbei.
Japan deserves a arena full to the brim after the, you know, unfortunate circumstances of the Olympic Games. All that effort with no crowd, you know, couldn't help but feel sorry for them. Course, but the guy will be amazing.
7-10.
Shin will be there. Is she going to be in the round of 16 here as well? Good match point.
10-8.
She's having a few issues here, trying to close this out. She's got the serve back now off this towel break. That could be decisive. Fu is, with all her experience, hanging in there. Three match points saved.
It's more oomph, I'd say. More intent behind her play here. Is it too little, too late?
We'll see. Fourth match point.
10-9.
Could you believe it? Used the timeout earlier here. Hasn't worked out yet. One more match point for Shin here.
Oh. 10-0.
All five have come and gone.
Would you believe it? The sensei with an exemplary comeback.
Two clear point winning margin. Fu, six of the last eight.
10-11.
Had the momentum there, and now has here the opportunity. What a steal this would be. Game point for the Portuguese.
11-0.
The irony of that situation there. Able to win so many, but not your own game point.
I know. It's been a tense matchup, this. Talked about the first game here again.
12-11.
And you feel it, it's palpable. You know, come to these events. It's something, when you're in the arena, you feel that. What a privilege to be here. Shin here, trying her hardest here to get this done this time. Fu's had a game point. This now is match point number six for Shin.
13,
does it this time.
11.
One of the stars of world table tennis right now, Xin Yubin, showing just her maturity at a young age there in getting the better of an extremely experienced quality opponent in Fuyu. Straight games in the end. Doesn't really tell the tale of that. It was tight, but she has won it 3-0 in the end. 13-11 in that third and final game. There it was then, how it finished. Finally, with the drive. Triumphant raised arm there. Could have easily, Fu there could have won at least a game in that one. Had her chances. But all smiles, an infectious smile that she's got on the show. Xin there, 14-12. 7-7, 13-11 there. Not too many longer streaks as well. And actually not much of a chasm in points won on the service either. Just did enough, didn't she, in the big moments, the key points in that one, Xin. So, the Korea Republic standout is through. What's her compatriot going to do here? Lim Jong-hoon, the 26-year-old, taking on the Australian youngster, the teenager, Nicholas Lum, for a round of 16 place. And that one here in the Infinity Arena is coming up in a few moments' time.
Bebe un chipitito de coquito con mantecadito, baby. Estas son las cosas que haces por amor, para romper las cadenas del tesoro. Son las vibras de la noche, yo lo mantengo y siempre lo gocé. Son las vibras de la noche, siempre son más de las doce, yo lo mantengo y lo rompe. Mujeres de oro que rompe, saca la botella, gozando la vida. Mujeres bonitas que rompe. Sudando con tiros, ahora es el único momento que cuenta. Con paciencia, mi presencia rompe, rompe, rompe. De cualquier manera, rompe, rompe, rompe. De cualquier manera. White lights turn gold, black nights turn gold. Bright light my soul. Everything like gold, black nights turn gold. Bailar my soul, bailar my soul, bailar my soul. No bregan con mi brillo, hace mucho calor. Siempre activo, sudando con tiros. Ahora es el único momento que cuenta. Con paciencia, mi presencia rompe. Son las vibras de la noche, siempre son más de las doce. Yo lo mantengo y lo rompe. Mujeres de oro que rompe. Saca la botella, gozando la vida. Mujeres bonitas que rompe.
Once again here to the Infinity Arena, round of 32 action continuing here. The opening day, 8 days of main draw action here at the WTT Champions Frankfurt. Straight knockouts. The round of 32 over the first few days. This is what's happened most recently in this opening session of play. And good results for Korea Republic in these matches. Lee Sang-soo getting his first career win over Timo Boll, ending Boll's chances at the first hurdle. And Xin Yubin just now surviving Fu Yu, 3-0, but a lot tighter than that in that one. What's her compatriot going to do now? Lim Jong-hoon to play Nicholas Lum.
From the Republic of Korea, please welcome for the next match, Lim Jong-hoon.
Lim Jong-hoon here on his way out the Infinity Arena for his round of 32 match here. The world number 17 to take on world number 35, teenager Nicholas Lum. for a round of 16 spot here. This is the last match of the day session. Once again, it will be played best of five games, first to 11 points, 2-point clear winning margin needed here. Best of five through to the semi-finals, semis in the final of these draws to be played best of seven. 10 of the table, not surprisingly, really, it's a first meeting between these two. Lum is in many ways a very talented junior youth player who's trying to make his way into the main, if you like, the top table of world table tennis here. Lim, though, is very established in the top 20. He's been just outside the world's top 10 this season as well. Very good in singles and doubles. Lim Jong-hoon, top performer and the favourite here. Kirsten Duschatz, the umpire for this one.
Black, blue for you, red for you. Red, please receive, you serve, this side, okay.
Nicholas Lum definitely has the longest trip to Frankfurt, the 18-year-old player from Melbourne, Australia.
Still Guy and Fraser with you here for this one. He's knocking up Fraser. Nicholas Lum here, 18 years of age. I mean, what? It's great for everyone to play this event, but particularly for someone where he's at, to be on this stage in Frankfurt. You can only learn from this, right?
This will be a fantastic experience for the young player here. Lefty-lefty, so that could help him out in a sense. Lim Jong-hoon would probably rather play a righty. Might diffuse a little bit. But yeah, I expect nothing less than a Lim Jong-hoon 3-0 in this encounter with his experience, power. I just think he'll be too hot to handle.
Yeah, he's competing for his share of the $500,000 total prize fund here. 1,000 ranking points, world ranking points on offer to the champion this week, as well as $30,000 US, the winner's check here overall. And look at the equipment they're playing with. Of course, it's the best because we have the best here. Insane. Why wouldn't it be any other way? Fan vote is going the way of Lim at the moment, very heavily. Sure, Nicholas Lum has got plenty of fans though, and if you are one of his, sign up, cast your vote, worldtabletennis.com. Get involved and try and maybe even up that vote or extend it more Lim's way. He'll be saying, why can't I get 90?
First game, Lum to serve, love all.
Last match of the day session here then in the Infinity Arena in Frankfurt. Nicholas Lum here, world number 35, 18 years of age. Continental standout in his career. That's why his ranking is up here. He's directly entered, but he's got a very tough opponent here in Lim Jong-hoon. Top 20 start from Korea Republic.
Three, there he goes.
He's just so strong, so solid. Real heavyweight presence about Lim whenever he's at the table. But this young man is a shot maker as well.
Well, they both have an incredibly strong base. You can see the definition in the legs. But Lim, another beast from the Far East, as you quite rightly say, in that same kind of weight class as Dapon Big Fatty Liang Jinquin, as he's known. Belovedly by the Chinese fans, of course.
Two, three.
Lim is an incredible flicker of the ball. He can get on the front foot straight away with that receive. So Nicholas Lum will have to try and suffocate that straight from the serve.
Left, two, three.
It's one of the reasons why Lim and Shin are top three in the world in mixed doubles.
Left. Two, three.
Well, they just combine so well. Yeah. Those strengths that complement each other.
Four,
straight
two.
Back at Lum. It's a good start there. Four of the first 6 points for Lim. But for Lum here, this is just such an... for everyone, as I say, it is. It's a big opportunity. But for him, where he's at... Oh, five, he doesn't two. Need that, does he, from them? Ridiculous net cord there.
The dribbler.
Three, five.
For Lum as well, actually. I saw quite a bit of him about a year ago, commentated the Commonwealth Games. He had a very good games.
Great. Four,
and I saw he had quality there. But I come back to the point I was making to you, Fraser, before, that still think of him as this kind of younger talent.
Mm.
You know, you're used to at WTT Champions level. You know, these players are extremely well established. They've got titles, everything else, big titles.
Five,
he doesn't have that yet, but what he's got is he's got ability, and he's fully fit now. Had a bad back injury after those good performances in Birmingham at the Commonwealths. And you often say, if you've got a bad injury like that, how long it takes you to come back and be 100% again?
Six, five.
Well, in the modern era, it takes less time, but still, it's so tough to come back. Mentally as well, you might be a little bit ginger in your movement, a little bit wary that it's going to come back again if you exert yourself too much.
Can't pick that up below the height of the table there, and Lim through to the second towel break, leading by two again.
They both have extremely physically taxing styles. Why it's rare to see an out-and-out aggressor play beyond the age of around 30.
Oh, six, seven.
Beautifully done how he picked that up. And maybe why you would say, can be different reasons, but with the back injury as well, such a physical style when you're only at that point 17, 18 years of age, you're not finished growing at that point.
Eight,
oh,
six.
He's got that ridiculous net, and now I think he's got a back edge as well.
Yeah, after that gorgeous grease from Lum, that is just going to be nothing but insult to injury.
Nine, six.
He's done all right this game, Nicholas Lum. However, Lim is going to get more used to this style and the spin coming in. Because you get a different kind of quality off each opponent.
6-10.
There, look at the length on that, the bat breaker. We see people get injured trying to go for shots like that. Christian Carlsen and Haramoto have cut their hand up and trying to go for loops off a half long.
11-6.
The game got away from Lim in the end after a bright start. Lim pulls away with it off the Australian. That game is done in the end in Lim's favour, taking it 11 points to 6 in the end. Offering their encouragement, particularly the way of Nicholas Lum here.
Second game
down.
Lim to serve.
To Lim Jong-un.
Love all.
See if he can start game two as well as he did the first.
Love one.
Struck that beautifully. Curled the wrist back. Timed it wonderfully. Low posture. Giving Lim Jong-un a taste of his own medicine there.
Love one. Left, love, one.
His fundamentals are very good. You can't really fault the technique of Nicholas Lum.
Right. Two, love.
Wait.
He plays his, Lum plays his league table tennis, Oeschenhausen. About the German Bundesliga.
Three.
And he's over the table there. I mean, that's something that, Lim's compatriot Lee Sang-soo would have liked that in terms of right hand over the table. That's brilliant.
Yeah.
Perfect play.
1-3.
Lim with his flick is doing different things. There's the top spin one, and there's the one that has a little bit more side spin. He contacted that one slightly more centrally, so less top spin than Nicholas Lim thought there was.
1-4.
He's acquitting himself well here, Lim. Saw it early in the first game here, 4 of the first 5 in game 2.
4-2.
Through to the towel break, despite that, he leads by a couple here. There's a lot of chat, isn't there, Fraser, about that, about the ranking? Okay, you've had that injury, 18 years of age. Whether it helps to be ranked, I mean, he is where he is because of his continental performances, yeah. Oceania performances. But 35 in the rankings. You know, whether that's a good thing. I guess you just make the argument this sort of opportunity is going to fast-track you potentially. I mean, there's the potential to do that.
He's going to have to start taking advantage of the fact that he's placed very nicely, often in, straight into the main draw of big events. Yes, being from a country like Brazil or Australia allows you to get a lot of points that you might not be able to do if you weren't from those places.
And
we're not going to comment on that. Because no matter where you're from, no matter which continent you play in, you deserve that. Being the king of your continent, you deserve that. Heavy weighting, if you can go far in continental events. But I feel like he will be surpassed if he doesn't start getting through the initial rounds.
4-5.
He will be able to use his ranking as leverage, though, to get better training in certain areas. And I think moving to Germany is a sensible decision.
5-0.
Germany is the, you know, main hub of Europe in many senses, with clubs like Dusseldorf, Starbuck and Oschenhausen.
5-6.
Such a good push there from Lim. Takes the lead here for the first time in this second game.
Seven-5.
They trailed by 4, didn't they? One point here. Now leading by 2, turning it round. 7-5. Just underlining that 6 of the last 8 points now for Lim Jong-hoon.
8-5.
So slow, so much rotation there. Nicholas Lim trying to play the captain hook forehand, come round the side of it. That would have been gorgeous.
5-9.
Very hard to execute, though.
And continuing here for Lim. Of course, he never really got flustered being behind early in the game.
Left. 5-9.
Why would he? Ranked and experienced as he is.
6-9. 9-7.
Over the table again. He's shown some quality. You talked about him having good fundamentals. He's had some good shot executions from the Australian.
Yeah. High and shallow. Made it easy for him to come over, but still. Very well done.
10-7.
It's all about the fundamentals, the average level, the middle ground.
11-7.
That's where Lim is showing the difference, showcasing it. Another game in the bank here in Frankfurt for Lim Jong-hoon. One more required for progress. Two games up then now, the Korea Republic man. 11-7, the second game is his. Top seeds in this event, this WTT Champions Frankfurt, Fun Zhendong in action at the end of the evening. The world champion heading the seedings here. Big Chinese flavour, of course. Liang Jingkun is involved as well in the next session of play. But we also have other nationalities represented, not least Dmitry Ovcharov in there, the sixth seed. Top German man in this draw.
Felix Lebrun there as well, the European Games champion, the silent assassin. The strength in depth is just amazing. I mean, it is every generation. But we're seeing more interesting metrics coming in, such as a European pen
third
holder
game,
in the top 10.
Long to serve. Love all.
So good for the sport and for the interest of it.
Left. Love all.
Spoke about the Yang guy. He's playing Alexei Lebrun in a Macau rematch, and the winner of this plays the winner of that.
One love.
I think you wanted to know about what Nicholas Lum is coming into here, this WTT Champions Frankfurt. That section of the draw you've just talked about, highlighted, tells you everything you need to know about the stacked quality.
Love two.
He's certainly shown here, he's two down, but you know, he's starting very well again. He started the games very well. Just hasn't quite been able to pull it through. What's gone on?
Left. Love two.
There you go.
One, yeah. Two.
And it's like he doesn't look, he's really trying that hard there, Lim Jong-hun. I mean, he's absolutely nailed that.
Well, this is the thing, if you try too hard, you'll probably miss. You've got to stay loose.
Three,
that's
one.
Where the speed comes from, and we saw it there on that winner from Lum. Oh, the
three,
serve was lovely.
Two.
Long and back spinny. Stepped around straight away. Newlin was going to try and spin. Maybe just went slightly too big.
2-4.
But you're right, Guy. He has got off to a good start in you know, most of the games. Maybe shows that he's maybe stopped and thought about it a little bit too much.
Mm. See where he sticks with it here. Can stick onto the lead this time.
Five.
Shake of the head from Lim. This is where he made that recovery in game two. From this sort of position in the scoreline.
5-3.
Fortunate.
But still, you can't help but admire the physicality of Lim Jong-hoon on these balls here. From his left leg through to his right.
4-6.
Fooled there by the serve, though. Subtle change. Imparted some topspin on it.
4-7.
Well played, young man.
Look how low he gets.
Seven, five.
That was laced.
This is the annoying thing about table tennis sometimes. How you can play a point like that and then miss a serve. Goes to show how much you have to be constantly open-minded and relaxed enough to know when you have to adapt and how you need to adapt. Also, how you need to make your opponent adapt. So there's so many things to think about.
Left, 7-5.
The irony of it is, often, the more you think about it, the harder it is to play. You've got to kind of let all the training speak for itself.
Oh, 8-5.
Another one. He has produced some quality moments here, Lum. Another one to add to the learning experience.
He's leant back as he's played that with the racket finishing above the head. Miracle.
6-8.
So, don't leave it two here for Lum. done a much better job of, we're now getting into the back end of the game, still leading.
Three.
Nice. Slaps that away. The Aussie to put the lead back up to three.
Well, for a player that lost in the round of 64 at the Singapore smash to Kuo and Pang, this is much improved here from Nicholas Lum.
10-6.
Maybe looks a little bit stunned here, Lim, with this run from Lum. 4 game points.
Left, 10-6.
Foul serve. 3 more game points for Lum.
Game
is Lim misses out on the receive, and Lum has his first game of the contest here in Frankfurt. Trails now 2 games to 1 to Lim here, having taken the third. 11-7. Let's just have a look here at some of Nicholas Lum's big moments so far that have got him back in to this particular match. About to head into a fourth game here. This is the last match of the day session. Much more to come, though, later. And through the week here in Frankfurt.
Fourth game, Lim to serve. Love all.
WTT Champions level, debutant Nicholas Lum here. Trailing now 2-1.
One love.
It's pretty special way there to begin game 4. Lim Jong-hoon here, still in front. Just gets the edge there, sending that through.
Nice fade, albeit.
Well,
you know, to get a game against one of the hardest hitters and coldest spitters in the world of table tennis, 3-time world championship medalist Lim Jong-hoon, is a victory in itself for Nicholas Lum. What I'm thinking here is, guy, does he kind of get too happy with that and become complacent, or does he build on that and
time
just
out.
Kind of press the reset button?
Well, he's pressed for the timeout. And lost the first 3 points of that fourth game. Lum here.
Sich nochmal zu überlegen, mit welcher Taktik es gleich weitergeht in 50 Sekunden, wenn dieses Timeout, was immer 1 Minute lang ist, vorbei ist.
There as well for Jusei Hyuk to speak to Lim as well, but it was called by Australians, by Min and Lum there.
Left, love, 3.
See whether it does anything here. Change the outcome of this fourth game.
4, love.
And immediately.
It's a horrible feeling being 2-0 up and your opponent gets a game back. You do not want it to go to a fifth. Lim playing with more intensity here.
It was just the way he strode back out, I think, after, as you say, the way he started pre the timeout, those first 3 points, there's no interest in going to a fifth.
No.
Oh. Love.
And there, that kind of underlines it. He's just keen to get this done as quickly as he can. He's running away now.
It's poetry in motion. The sweep of that. I mean, Lund winning that game, it was like a red rag to a bull.
One, six.
Oh, yeah. Nicely done. Flight of that service there. And the pitch of it as well.
No spin on it, and Lim tried to do a dummy loop. Fresh aired it.
Great. 6-3.
3 points in a row.
He had a fantastic run in Xingshang, Lim, you know, where he nearly beat Fan Jendong, lost in seven after beating Tomokazu Hadamoto. But he would love to get more success in singles, I feel.
3-7.
It's funny, he's put that into there, but I mean, that's a great pickup, isn't it, from Lim as well. You think where he is relative to the table, the feeling.
Gorgeous.
Yeah, a lot of the focus is on the guy's miss there, but you've got to think why.
Yeah, no, it was great intricacy, wasn't it?
Oh. 4-7.
Oh, Lim, Lim's nodding there. He would have liked that one himself.
Really hard to play the white of the line there.
8-4.
The big problem here for Lim is just the fact that he fell those 3-4 points adrift immediately. It's tough at this level. We talk about the learning experience where he's at in his young career. Any sorts of dips, you've been alluding to it, they get punished by these top players.
9-4.
The top players are the players who are best at playing each point on its own merit. It's so much easier said than done.
4-10.
There and waiting. And he's waiting for the round of 16 here. Shouldn't have to wait too long for it now. Lim Jong-hun fizzes that through. 6 match points.
5-10.
It's all over. Entertaining encounter that to conclude the day session. Lim Jong-hun, the winner there in 4 games. Nicholas Lum showing his quality though, the teenager. Not disgraced by any means. Loses out in the end though, 3-1 to Lim. 11-5 in that fourth game in the end. So Lim, who reached the semi-finals of the WTT Champions event in Xinjiang this season, off and running here. But Lim showing everyone here in Frankfurt what he's about. Played very well, had those early leads in the first couple of games, won the third. Just Lim was able to get away in the fourth and ended up winning that in 4 games, 25 minutes overall. For the Korea Republic man, and he is safely through to the round of 16. I mean, a really entertaining first session of the week here. Let's just recap it before we let you go. Sabina Winter for the German player there first up. Wang Jujin and Chen Meng not really troubled in either of their matches. Also 3-0 successes for them there. So the Chinese favourites moving through pretty routinely there in that first half of the session. And in the matches we've seen just now, in addition to Lim's win there, well, joy for Korea Republic. Lee Sang-soo with his first win over Timo Boll, and Shin Yu-bin, top 10 star, seeing off the Portuguese veteran Fu Yu there by a straight games scoreline. There we go then. What a start to the week here in the thrilling centre that is Frankfurt. Thanks to your company. We hope you can join us later on for a brilliant evening session to come. Fan Jendong headlining it. Thanks to your company. We'll hopefully see you later. For now, from Frankfurt, it's goodbye.